night. In the beginning, Geraldo Rivera was somewhat sympathetic to the movement.
The crowd is easy to mock. They are disorganized. They look funny. Some, like the person putting the paper in front of the lens, are aggressive. But they have a real legitimate complaint deep down. And it is a message that I think will resonate eventually as people listen up.
Here now is Mr. Rivera. Well, eventually has come. And here you are.
I am.
And it's not resonating. The people have turned against the movement.
I don't agree. I don't think
you don't agree with the poll.
Well, I think the Quinnipiac poll can be read as saying that it's a virtual tie between those who are in favor and those who are opposed to Occupy Wall Street, 39-30.
But the big
swing. That's pretty darn close.
But the swing in a 3-week time, I mean, from 58% down to 30%.
Let me cut to my personal chase. I deplore violence. I'm a cop's man. I think that anyone who raises their hand to a police officer deserves to get the weight of the law thrown against them. These crazy people, there are crazy people everywhere, and indeed they are attracted. The Turco wrestling champion of the Zuccotti Park right there pushing down the crazy guy. But he, the fellow that got thrown down to the sidewalk, as he should have been, is a Clevelander who is mentally incompetent, I am told. Inevitably, when there's free food and lodging and a social environment, homeless people or street people are attracted to it. They are not the majority, and I think the newspapers that are hyping the violence, I think it's very unfortunate. They
it's
have
not
already
hyping the violence.
They have
this
already
is what it's all about.
They've already accomplished.
Look, Geraldo, you've been around long enough to understand this. There's no central authority down there, and if you want to go down there and cause trouble, you can, and nobody's going to stop you.
As you can in
Oakland,
Times Square or any place else.
Yeah, but they don't do it there because there isn't a shield to protect you.
But what's your
this
big
is
beef?
A
is it that they're
Here's
loitering?
My big beef. I'm glad you asked. Here's my big beef, all right? This whole movement has been hijacked by anarchists, communists, and crazy people. They dominate now. And the good, sincere protesters, and there were some, are afraid of them.
You know what strikes in my mind? The phrase old fogey, because what you just said was used time and time again against the anti-Vietnam War protesters. You emphasize the people on the
edges. So you're
edges,
justifying all this violence.
Look at I justify
it.
None, and you're putting words in my mouth, and it's not appreciated.
If you weren't,
it's not
if
true.
You weren't justifying
it. I said specifically that anyone who raises their hand to a police officer, the reason the civil rights movement worked is it was nonviolent. It was essentially nonviolent by good law-abiding people. It is essentially nonviolent also.
No, it is not.
I only know Zuccotti Park. I've been down there far more often.
You can't see the pictures out of California?
I see the pictures out of Oakland, California. I lament it, and I believe that to a certain extent, the G20-type anarchists took over in Oakland.
That's just what I said.
That happened in one night, and it happened.
It happened in Denver. It's happened in Texas.
Come to the home port of Occupy Wall Street, Zuccotti Park, downtown New York, and look at what these young people, largely young people, who are frustrated by not only the fact that the fat cats got off scot-free and took their hundreds of millions of dollar bonuses back home to Greenwich, Connecticut, and none of them were prosecuted for what were some of the most egregious crimes that accelerated and exacerbated our economic decline.
Look, put
that aside. Here's what they have already accomplished. They brought more attention to the economic disparity, the growing income gap in this country than any political force has. President Obama has now suggested that he will pass a holiday on student loans that will limit the student loan repayment to 10% of the discretionary income of the borrower. So when a kid's graduating with $25,000 in student loan facing this uncertain job market, he gets a break.
And who pays for that in the long run?
But isn't that a nice thing?
Look,
isn't that a good thing?
All right, you've had.
And tomorrow,
now I just, look, hold it. Hold it. I just gave you 2 minutes. Now you're going to listen to me.
All right? I have another point.
Okay.
So I reserve my right of rebuttal.
Here you go. Okay. You just said that Wall Street fat cats got away with crimes. Okay?
Don't you agree with that?
No, I don't. Because there is no crime. And if there were,
it's no crime
that would
to
mean,
bundle
hold
subprime
it.
Mortgages hold and sell
no.
them as AAA securities?
No, there isn't. It isn't on the books. And if it were on the books, what is Obama and Holder doing about it? They've been in office for 3 years. So the occupiers should be marching on the White House and the Justice Department if what you say is true. Not terrorizing citizens down in lower Manhattan. If what you say is true, that these people weren't prosecuted by the government and should have been, then all of these people should be after Obama and Holder, right?
I think that the script has not yet been written, the final chapter of what happens and the people who can be held
responsible. You made the statement that they got away with crimes.
They are so far absolutely getting away with, I think, a crime against
the
economy of their
country. Well, they had 3 years the Obama administration to prosecute, and they haven't prosecuted any of them.
I believe that the Congress is dysfunctional. I believe the president and the Congress are...
No, it's the Justice Department. They bring the cases. Congress doesn't bring the cases.
The cases are not yet all brought that will be brought in a lot of time. We need the Volcker rule. We need a lot of... Here, tomorrow, there's a bank transfer day. This is a concrete thing. They are saying, take your money out of the Bank of America, take your money out of J.P. Morgan Chase, take your money out of these big banks and put them in small credit unions. What if that comes out to tens of millions of dollars in bank transfer? I got to go.
Nobody's going to do that. Number one, those people don't have any money. And nobody's going to listen to them because they lost credibility.
Well, let's let your viewers watch the news on Sunday and see what they do.
All right, watch Geraldo, and if he gets wind of any transfer, he'll let you know.
I will indeed. I would transfer from O'Reilly.